might have a mom, she might be the bomb, but ain't nobody.
Happy Mother's Day!
Happy Mother's Day!
Happy Mother's Day!
Nobody got a mom like mine.
We love your moms.
We love your moms.
Let's do a Mother's Day craft together for our moms.
Hi everyone, in preparation for Mother's Day, we wanted to give you a simple craft, an activity that you could do at home and give it to your mom as a special gift. So there's a couple different things that you're gonna need today. You're gonna wanna get some construction paper. I picked out some different colors. A larger piece of construction paper or just a regular piece. I'm going to cut this actually in two pieces, so you can use a regular size piece. Another variation you can do of this activity is using tissue paper. So sometimes you've got tissue paper lying around from gifts and things. You could do tissue paper with colors, or you could even do white paper and use markers to color it. That's an option too. I have a glue stick, and then I also have some clear packing tape, which I'll use with the tissue paper. But I'm going to get started by showing you the version that uses the construction paper. So what I'm going to do with this paper is I'm just going to cut it in half so I can have a heart shape. We're going to make some heart sun catchers. I'm going to leave this one over here for later. And this piece is going to be a heart. So what we're going to do is I'm going to go ahead and trace the shape of a heart right here. And you might wanna get some help tracing the shape of a heart, or if you wanna try it on your own, you can do that. Maybe dad can help you. You can do a secret project for mom. So I'm gonna cut out the shape of the heart. Now, in order for it to be a sun catcher, I need space in the middle. So after I cut out this heart shape, I'm actually going to cut a smaller shape so that it's kind of an outline. So I'm just gonna move my scissors in a little bit and cut around so that there's an outline of our heart. So again, this might be something that dad can help you with, or an older sibling can help you get started. So now you have the outline of a heart, and this is what you're gonna use for your sun catcher. So now I'm gonna take my construction paper pieces. And this is where you can get creative. You don't have to use any certain amount of colors. You can use whatever colors you want. And I'm gonna take my paper and just cut it into thin strips. So you can make them go thin like that. And probably do maybe, I don't know, maybe three or four of each color. Or if you're using white paper, you can color your white paper, whatever amount of colors you want. Just enough to, we're gonna cover the heart with these pieces. So I got four pieces of my pink paper, and I'm gonna do some blue. It's always fun to make something special for mom to show her how much you appreciate her. There's lots of different things that you can give her. I hope you guys have special plans to celebrate Mother's Day this weekend. I got my blue, and I'm gonna do my purple next. These are really good skills to work on too, with fine motor skills and cutting. Cutting a straight line. You could even do, if you wanted to make it your own, you could do not straight lines, you could do curvy lines. I'm doing the straight lines because they're actually going to cross each other in the sun catcher, so that's why I'm doing the straight lines, so I can have strips of paper. If you didn't want to work on cutting, you could even tear the paper and do torn paper and just glue everything onto one piece of paper altogether. That way you can make it your own too. I can show you that later if you want. But once I get my strips, I'll show you what we're gonna do with them. And then before the end of this video, I'll show you another way that you can make it using the tissue paper, which might be a little bit more appropriate for younger children. So I've got my strips of paper, and I'm gonna go ahead and take my glue stick and put my glue on the heart shape. Now I'm just gonna do the top part right now because I don't wanna make the glue dry out too much. And then just kind of start taking your strips of paper and putting them in all different directions. You can make a design if you want. You could even make a pattern, but it doesn't have to be any certain way. They can just cross each other, go across like that. Make sure you're putting it down where you have glue up in this top section. So now that that part's glued down, I'm gonna go ahead and add more glue up here and start gluing down some more strips. I'm gonna get some purple over here. Glue that down. So what I'm doing now, I'm putting the glue on the top part, and then once I glue the top part on, I'm gonna actually go down the bottom of the heart outline and glue the rest of the pieces together. So we kind of want to get all the pieces lined up so that we can finish gluing them all on. And then we'll turn it over and see what it turns out to look like. Got a couple extra pieces, so I'm going to add them down at the bottom. You can take your glue, you can put it wherever you want on your heart shape, your heart outline. So I've got all the beginning strips glued on. So now I'm actually going to take my glue stick and go around the whole outline of the heart and make sure that all the strips of paper are attached. Anywhere where they're not attached, you're going to want to put some glue down to make sure that it stays. So glue that down. You could even glue the pieces together if you wanted to. Glue right here so it's together. And then glue that one down. I'm going to glue these top pieces down. And then... So I've got them all glued on, but now I've got some extras on here. So I'm going to take my scissors again and just kind of trim the pieces towards the edge of the heart outline so that they're not hanging off. Almost all the pieces cut, and then we're gonna be all done. So when you're done, it turns out looking like this. And so you could hang it on a string if you wanted to. You could fold it up and make it into a card. You could just give it to your mom like that. And this is a great gift, a simple thing that you can do at home. You don't have to spend money on it, but you can make her a nice heart that she would enjoy that shows her how much you love her. So we could do another design the same way, but using tissue paper. So I'm gonna do the same thing as I did before. I'm gonna make my heart shape. And then I'm gonna make the outline. So move my scissors in a little bit. I'm kind of cutting out the middle of the heart, so that I have an open middle part to work on. And this time, instead of using the glue, I'm going to use some of the clear packing tape. And I'm gonna kind of try to measure a little bit what the space is that I need. I'm not gluing it to the table, I'm just putting the pieces down so that they, so that they'll attach to the paper. So put a couple strips down just to cover the inside of the heart over the whole outline. up like this. If you have contact paper at home, that's another thing that you can use. It's sticky on one side, but it's not on the other. Most of you probably have packing tape at home, so I thought that would be an easy alternative for you to be able to make this sun catcher with tissue paper instead. And like I said before, this might be an easier activity to do for younger children with the tissue paper because they can just tear it and stick it onto the sticky part of the heart. So this takes a little bit of setup, but once you get the tape on there, it'll be simple for you to turn it over and start sticking things too. So I've got all of my strips of paper covered. I'm just gonna peel this off the table so that I can start decorating it on the other side. The tricky thing with packing tape is it gets stuck easily. So I've got that all set, and now I'm going to turn it over and use my tissue paper and just tear some pieces and stick it on. I got some different colors of tissue paper, so you can tear little strips of it. You can make little balls if you wanted to. You can do however many colors you want. I'm going to add in some yellow on mine. You could even do this one if you wanted to, like our first one, and cut the tissue paper into lines or cover it all in one color, whatever you think your mom would like best since it's a gift that you're giving her. So I'm just adding in all the different colors to cover up the heart outline. Purple. I have green and I haven't added any green, so I'm gonna grab some green here too. I'm gonna add the green, starting to fill in. So to finish this off, you could do a couple of different things. If you wanted to, you could cut around the edge and cut the rest of the tape off. You could always take another piece of paper, like this one, and stick the heart onto that, and then that would be the full paper that you make. Or you could take more tape and do another layer of tape over that. So since I have the paper, I'm gonna go ahead and put that over it, just to show a different idea. And now you have a heart that has some paper, and then you can just trim the extra tape off or fold it over, whatever is easiest for you. This is just a fun activity to do something special for mom and give her something that you made that's unique. I think that's my mom always loved the gifts that I made that were special just for her. So, we've got our heart, and you could write on here, Happy Mother's Day, if you wanted to, and give that to Mom on Mother's Day. So, it's just a fun activity to do for you to have something to give to Mom for Mother's Day, and make sure you celebrate her and tell her how much you love her. See ya.
Mom's all the best.
Let's read a book with our moms. The book we're going to read is Mother's Day Surprise.
Violet was a young snake. She liked to slide and slither and shed her skin whenever it got old. In her free time, Violet often played with the other animals. She raced the rabbits. She hung next to the bats. And she fooled around with the chipmunks. But as spring was sprung, Violet noticed a change in the air. The other animals were suddenly very busy, too busy to play. I Violet wondered why everyone was in such a hurry. "What's the rush?" she asked the fox trotting by. "Things to do," he said. Violet could see that. "What things?" she asked. But the fox was already gone. Violet looked around for anyone with a moment to spare. "What's going on?" she asked the skunk, digging in the dirt. "We're getting ready for Mother's Day," he explained. "Already?" said Violet. The skunk laughed. "Well, you can't start too soon. It takes time to make the perfect gift." Violet had to admit that was true. But what kind of gift would be perfect for her mother? Violet watched as a squirrel sorted through a pile of acorns. He was very picky about it. "Why are you being so fussy?" Violet asked. "They're for my mother," said the squirrel, "and she likes them crunchy." Next, Violet saw a bear crushing some honeycomb. "That looks like a sticky work," said Violet. The bear agreed, "but I have to do it right. My mother likes things done just so." Then Violet saw a beaver chomping on the fallen tree trunk. "What are you doing?" Violet asked. "Shh," said the beaver. "Don't disturb artists at work." "Sorry," said Violet. "I can't afford to make any mistakes," the beaver went on. "When I'm done, my mother will love this." Violet was glad everyone was working so hard, but that wasn't helping her. What could she do for her own mother? Without arms, legs, or teeth, she couldn't make anything like the other animals. Never before had Violet felt it was so hard being a snake, but she felt that way now. As Mother's Day approached, Violet got sadder and sadder. The other animals were finishing up their gifts, and Violet still hadn't started hers. It wasn't fair. It wasn't fair at all. Then Violet got an idea. On the morning of Mother's Day, all the animals were ready with their presents. Violet was ready, too. "Happy Mother's Day," shouted Violet. "Oh my," said her mother. "What a surprise. It's perfect, Violet. Absolutely perfect." Violet was very happy. Even without arms, legs, or teeth, she had shown her mother just how she felt. And her mother felt the same way, too. Happy Mother's Day!
She's my world, she's my heart.
Happy Mother's Day from the Learning Tree.